Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Let me welcome you here on behalf of the party Občané.cz. Let me first introduce you our people. First, this is our chairman, Mr. Petr Havlík. This is bearded man. Then it is Ivan Pilný.
Good morning.
And Petr Bílek. I am Peter Peltz. Who are we? We are a party of citizens, deeply dissatisfied with the status quo, and who wish to bring about meaningful change. Občané.cz offer a platform to those citizens who have worked hard and honestly in the last 20 years. We have kept out of national politics. We welcome as members all those who are angered by the opportunism of the today's political class, and who believe that this country's potential, great though it is wasted.
In our country, we have basically two methods how to do it. The first one is to use sharp elbows in the darkness of parties' offices. This method was impossible to use because there was not enough elbows, definitely not 600 of them, and by June time, there was no party's office. So we set up the stage with benches. On the bench, there were sitting not only political representatives, but also some sympathetic celebrities. We have listened to coming people, to their problems and suggestions. We were accused by doing that we dishonest the politics. But we think that the ones who really dishonest the politics and leveled the politics with the floor was the recent political so-called elite. We assembled by this way also thousands of questionnaires where people suggested not only change but exchange of complete political scene.
Jaký je z vašeho hlediska pohled na rozmíšku, mohli to tak nazvat, mezi českým prezidentem Klausem a konstitucionálním soudem, tedy ústavním soudem?
Hello, I would like to ask you about your opinion about the current, let's call it, argument between the Czech president and the Czech constitutional court.
My se domníváme, že pan prezident ten problém uchopil nesprávným způsobem. Že napětí svým postojem k ústavnímu soudu spíše eskaluje a zatahuje do toho svým způsobem celou veřejnost. Já bych předpokládal, že pan prezident bude situaci spíše uklidňovat.
Now, this is a question I was kind of afraid of, but I'm not going to escape or avoid the answer. We actually believe that the Czech president kind of mishandled the situation, and his position actually escalates the tension between or with the constitutional court, and in a way his position makes the public be involved in the whole situation. I would expect the president to act more as a mitigator.
Úcta k právu a pořádku, k institucím a zákonům je základní hodnota, na které stojí náš program.
The respect of the law and order and basic value is the core part of our agenda.
A předpokládali bychom, že nejvyšší ústavní činitel bude vycházet ze stejných principů.
We would expect that the highest constitutional representative would act on the basis of the same values.
Našemu zklamání se tak v posledních týdnech neděje.
To our disappointment, this hasn't been the case over the last couple of weeks.
Nemusí se nám ústava líbit, nemusí se nám líbit mnohé jiné věci, ale třeba respektovat zákon a verdikt soudu.
We may not like the constitution or many other things, but we need to respect the law and the court's verdict.
Mohla proběhnout odborná diskuse, veřejná, uvnitř politiku, a místo toho jsme svědky nechutných šarvátek, kterým veřejnost přestává rozumět.
There should have been a professional political and public discussion, but instead of that discussion we are witnessing arguments which are not tasteful and the public is unable to understand them.
My jsme v našem stanovisku z minulého týdne řekli, že si možná v posledních událostech někteří poslanci konečně přečtou ústavu České republiky. A dokonce jsme vyslovili přání, že by bylo dobře, kdyby se podle ní začali konečně řídit.
Last week we issued our position in which we said that based on the current situation some deputies might actually finally read the constitution and eventually start acting on the basis of it.